All right, guys, we just got loaded up at the shipper, so let's go ahead and get the paperwork for this load. Right before we go and get the paperwork at the shipping office, we're gonna need to close the trailer door, so let's go ahead and do just that. We have a seal that they give us for the trailer. So all right, now we are less than a mile away from the truck stop that we are going to. Let's go ahead and slow down to about like 40 miles per hour. It should be right here on the white. Okay, let's get on the white lane and turn white. I'm hoping that is not going to be too busy for showers, because we don't really need I don't really need fuel right now. All I really need is just to take a shower and after that get right back on the freeway. Keep making my way west to making my way out west to Illinois. Right now we are about 230 miles away from Illinois. Can I park right here on this fuel line? I wish I didn't have to park. I wish I didn't have to park right here. But this truck is really on my way. Stopping me from parking, but the driver just get back in and it seems like it's about to move. Let's see if it's about to move. In the meantime, let me turn my clock off on off duty. It's servos parking out here. Okay, this truck is moving, so let's see if we can take one of these reserve parking. Okay, yes, now it's gonna be easy for us to take one of these reserve parking, even though it's not gonna be straight. I mean, there's two straight right here. Okay, let's go ahead and back it up straight and take one of these parking out here. Let me just go ahead and take this one. You know, I'm perfectly square to this one right here, so let's just go ahead and take this one. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. All right, guys, just like that, we're taking a little rest. I'm hoping it's not gonna be for too long, but hey, let's go ahead and take a quick shower and I'll be back after that.
Alright, now we are done with taking a nice hot shower and we are supposed to leave, but as I'm checking my white mirror, I'm seeing that my tires are looking a little bit funny. So let's go ahead and check it out. The way I'm looking at this tire is giving me a flat vibe. Okay? So tires on my tandems are good. But as I'm coming to my like trailer tire, this one is kind of missing some air. This one is definitely flat. Check this out. This one is definitely flat. And we need to call maintenance and get this fixed. Right now I am at Pilot, but right across the street it's a TA Travel Center. So usually at TA's they have a repair shop. Pilot don't have none, but TA has repair shop, and I'm about to call maintenance and see how I can handle this real quick. Right about now it's 5:50. We are still about 200 something miles away.
So okay, truck services. We need to go to truck services. And that's gonna be right ahead of us. Nah, for real, the truck breaks down at the right place, right time. I don't know what to say. I can park in the back. I can park right here. Let me just do a pull up right here, or let me go ahead and do a pull up right about here instead. Yeah, and this TA is full of parking spots, so either way we're gonna be good. So yeah, let's just go ahead and park right about here. And after that, we're gonna need to go in the office to go ahead and check in. So let's do that real quick. Before I leave, let me see. Hey buddy, what's up? The outside wheel tire, this one right here. Mm-hmm.
Back, and I'm gonna pitch up on a block of wood.
So heavy stop, I'll get the block wood down, move you back about a little foot. All right. Sounds good. He gonna take care of me real quick. That's a good thing.
And just like that, we are back in business. All right, let's go ahead and park so we can check out, you know, get the paperwork, all that good stuff. Yeah, for you guys that's thinking about getting your CDL, that's thinking about driving trucks, this is what pretty much a day in a trucker life is like, you know. And so far nothing too crazy, because it can get crazy when you drive 100 miles to a shipper to go pick up a load, just to find out another driver pick up this load already, you know. This ship is closed, this yada yada, you know. You almost made it to the shipper and your truck broke down, like literally like 5 miles away from the shipper, and your truck decided to break down and stuff, and now you're stuck. You gotta wait for like 5-7 hours just to get that thing fixed. So this is not bad at all. We had a flat tire on the trailer right across the street from a whipper shop. So let's keep on trucking, let's keep on driving. That's it. But now guys, the sun is really going down. In about 20-30 minutes from now, it's gonna be nighttime. It's gonna be all dark. I still got 180 miles to go, which is roughly about 3 hours. But I know once I get to the city of Chicago, it's gonna be traffic over there. Traffic, you know, with construction and stuff. But hey, let's go ahead and enjoy the sunset. You know, it's really nice. In the meantime, let me go ahead and turn on the truck light, because you know it's getting dark. So we're gonna be driving for like about like 3 hours. This night. So I'ma show you guys a little bit of what is it like, you know, driving at night. It's really nothing to see out here but the lines that's on the highway, you know. Except once we get to a city, like for example we're gonna get to Chicago, it's gonna be, you know, lights on the freeway, all that good stuff, lights on the building, the apartments all around the freeway. It's gonna be just about that. So stay tuned, we're gonna get to see it. And then where I'm going to park for tonight, I'm really not sure yet, but usually I like to park by the receiver, so that way when I wake up in the morning I can just go ahead and drop the load off. So let's see, I'm not tired yet, so since I'm not tired yet, I'm gonna keep pushing. Hopefully I can make it to the receiver tonight. It's really that for me. All right guys, we just got off the highway. Let's see what this small town has in store for us. We are about a mile away from the receiver. We taking on this white lane. Okay, I'm saying that it's a few store out here that I can come out and get me something to eat.
if I'm starving for the night. Guys, check this store out. It's called Portillo's. It's gotta be Mexican restaurant. And I never had that before. And it's less than a mile away from me, so I might walk up. I might walk up here and get me something to eat for tonight. Since we are going down the street, this not gonna be far at all. All right, at the stop sign, we wanna make a left. So let me check on Google Map where exactly I'm going. Okay, we are going to this building and the Dax is right in front of it. So how about we go and get in the Dax? So let me see if I can do that. If there's a sign that we cannot park at the dock, we're not going to. But if there's no sign, how about we just go ahead and park at the dock and wake up in the morning, just drop the load off. It's really that simple. So let's see what it's gonna be, but all out here, it's no problem if I park out here. I mean, I'm not seeing no parking sign, so it's good. It's pretty good. Okay, let me go ahead and turn on my four-way flasher. The place we're going to is this place. Guys, why is it giving that they are open? Alright, I'm about to go ahead and check in and see if they can take me tonight. If they want to take me tonight, I'ma let them do it. But my appointment is not until tomorrow morning. Let me go ahead and change my my duty status. Okay. It's giving that they're working tonight. So, okay, before I pull in, let me walk to them first. Let me do that. Let me go ahead and walk to them. 7 it is. Dock 7. So, let's just go ahead. Okay, Dock 7, let's just go ahead and we have enough room to get this thing in with no headaches. Just make sure no car is coming. Not.
All right, guys. Good day if you're watching this in the daytime. Good night if you guys going to bed just like me.